All right, coming up next, a matchup to determine the baddest man on the planet. The UFC heavyweight title is on the line. Well, you can argue this is the most influential martial artist of all time, the great Bruce Lee, making his walk to the octagon here tonight, champ.
Everybody wants to be Bruce Lee. They say they want to be like Mike. If you're a fighter, you want it to be like Bruce Lee. You want it to be that fast. You want it to be that charismatic. You want it to have an ability to just freeze your opponents. Your speed, your movement, just the diversity in the attacks that you can give your opponents would just confuse people. I mean, I watched him beat a 7-foot Kareem Abdul-Jabbar to stay undefeated.
Right.
If you could do that, you could do anything.
I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once. I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. Bruce Lee in a nutshell.
Just so wise.
Well, a lot of people think it's the most significant title in combat sports. No argument from me. Baddest man on the planet, UFC heavyweight champion. There he is in the flesh. What an absolute monster. What a title reign it has been. But a serious challenge in front of him here tonight. When this man became the heavyweight champion, a lot of people thought that this challenger was the one who would wrest the belt away. Now the fight is here. We'll see if we get a new champion or if this man continues one of the greatest heavyweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. And now let's get you our tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. So 2 years, the gap in age, with some differences in height, but the same reach. We send it inside the Octagon. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. Championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, presenting the challenger, Bruce the Dragon Lee. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 242 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, ladies and gentlemen, presenting a reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Assassin.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves this month.
This fight gets underway, and it'll be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against another guy who can really do all.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Big kick lands. Over and over, he's landing these big body kicks.
Oh, just misses with the kick.
real nice body kick. Nice kick.
Blocks that kick to the body.
Beautiful body kick.
Midway through round one.
Big powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
All right, single collar tie now.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Nice job with that follow-up shot as well. Oh, caught him with a head kick. That at least partially landed.
Oh my goodness, he got kicked in the head and he's still standing. Big punch land. Ooh.
That knee lands there.
That knee hurt him.
Big head kick. Oh! Final minute.
All right, here we go. Nice. Hey, let's finish this one strong. You're in control.
Oh, big knee to the body. How'd he get that one home? Oh, straight right. He engages in a single collar tie here. 15 seconds to go.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this?
All right, DC, let's look at some of the highlights from the last round. Lots for the replay guys to choose from.
Yeah, man, these guys stood on a quarter in the middle of the octagon. Take one to give one. Over and over, each guy landed, and they both landed very well over the course of that first round.
All right, here we go as our next round gets underway. That was some serious precision striking on display in the previous round. Found his openings upstairs and closed the show.
He has landed at an alarming rate. His opponent needs to get his head off the center line. He's walking into him with his head straight up, not moving, trying to engage without changing the angles. That is why he is getting brutalized right now. Beautiful strike. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Boom! Well, he's got the kicking game going tonight. Lands another one there.
A beautiful kick, and all I can think of, better him than me.
He's got a serious right kick.
What a beautiful uppercut. It landed beautifully. Perfect placement on that shot.
Back to the feet. So he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're going to have to put something on your opponent that's going to really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight. He has a commitment to kick it tonight, and it shows.
Ooh-wee.
Ooh-wee, what a right hand by this young man.
I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he is on Beach Street right now. He's seeing Tweety Bird over the top of his head. If you take a hook like that, you are on wobbly legs.
So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Score that
takedown. Oh. He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad. looking for a finish.
Oh, big left hook there.
Straight punch lands.
Back and forth we go. Seconds to go in this one.
Big kick lands.
Try to establish that jab. Ten minutes in the books. Gotcha, there's the horn signifying the end of the round. A stunner there with the head strike midway through. Nearly got him out of there for good.
Almost got him out of there. He hurt him badly. He had his opponent hurt real bad. Now, his opponent's walking back to his corner. Everybody looks confused. They don't know what they're supposed to do to try to change the way that this fight is going.
All right, next round is now underway. Hopefully the action continues at a high level. Pretty good first 5 minutes.
Pretty good first 5 minutes. Both of them can really pick it up. Let's see who decides they're going to lead the dance as we go forward. Yes, that he hurt him in the last round. Same exact one.
Oh, and there's a kick now to the body. That one blocked by Lee.
Good punch.
Combination lands for him. He is really putting his strikes together tonight.
I mean, he's feeling himself tonight, John. He's doing a great job of putting everything together. John, he's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh, big left. Wow, what a kick. And now he lands a combination. This is exactly the sense of urgency you're looking for. Try to take the judges out of it. He is lighting them up now. Trying to do damage now with the kick. That's a miss.
Ooh, head kick lands. He's hurt.
Oh, he might be in trouble here after that big diving punch. Trying to guard pass here. Not today.
No, it ain't happening. Good job understanding the transitions.
Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going to stop
him. You got to defend. But you can see him now start to gain posture, and the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Oh, that's a beautiful kick right there. I don't know if you've ever been kicked by a mule. Probably feels something like that.
It has to. This guy is landing this kick with so much force.
Oh! Huge right hand!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Seconds left.
Real sneaky body kick.
And they set.
Oh,
oh,
what a sweep.
What a round. All right, let's check out some of the action, DC. What a display of just sheer punching in that last round.
I mean, he looks like a boxer. He looks like a professional boxer out there throwing and stringing those combinations together. He landed those big punches over and over again, and it was this one right here that really did change the tide of the round.
All All right, so here we go. Fourth round is underway. What is the fighter's mentality when you enter those seminal championship rounds?
You understand that you are getting close now. The night is almost over. The goal is within reach now. 15 minutes down, 10 to go. You tell yourself you can do anything.
Just unable to quite find that range.
Look at the angle of that nice body kick.
Well, most fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight.
Get those combinations going.
What a body kick. Great punch.
Whiffs on the straight leg. Oh, he's out!
He's done, he's done!
You knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short knife for his opponent, but that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight. So the celebration is on for the UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the baddest man on the planet, and your winner, yes, by knockout here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 1 minute, 17 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by...